Roguelikes are games where enemies, bosses and items are randomized, and if you die, you have to start all over again. So I took that concept and tried beating an Elden Ring randomizer run with permadeath, so every time we die, the whole game and seed resets. I came in pretty confident, like I beat this game countless times. The fact that enemies are shuffled around shouldn't be a problem, right? Okay, so yeah, I don't know if I should basically... So yeah, that was the first run, but we just have to get the hang of it. Attempt 2 is going a lot better, we even managed to meet Melina, and I decided that we can use spirit summons if we find them around. After scavenging a bunch, we have a +2 weapon, armor and even a summon, and since with this kind of equipment I can usually kill Margit easily, I make my way into the arena feeling pretty good.
Okay, that's horrible. Possibly one of the worst enemies?
And while I get slaughtered, two small things I didn't mention. The first one is that enemies are scaled based on who they are substituting, so that's why I thought this fight should be doable. And sacrificial twigs work as extra lives, they break when we die and they are pretty rare, so it makes sense to me. We die here, but since we had an extra life we can proceed, only to get stabbed while trying to climb towards the plateau. Perfumers 2, me 0. Run 3, same thing. We run around, get some equipment, enter the Margit fight and it's Makar, meaning too much lava around and we melt to death. Run 4 though started out well, we even beat the tutorial boss, and with some luck we can find a very strong summon and upgrade our weapon.
Okay, so we have the weapons, we have the summon, we have the healing flasks, we just need to be a bit lucky and not get like a dragon. Oh fuck.
Yeah, so Giant Phase 2 is probably the worst one we can find, and I was starting to lose confidence.
I'll put my foolish ambitions to rest, I guess.
Guess how round 5 went.
We even have like one more HP, so this should be the run.
Really?
Really? Really? Really? Really? Really?
Even with good equipment, lucky items and everything, the run were all looking the same. We explore, upgrade, get to Margit and just die. If we have a twig, we run around some more and then die to the next boss. So all we needed was some luck with the bosses, and maybe we can make it. And that's where run 6 comes in, with the best possible first boss.
Wait? Okay, it's still got the... No, really? No.
That was supposed to be the last try for the day, but I needed some dopamine, so I did one more run and ran straight for the Soldier of Godric substitute. That is supposed to be the easiest boss in the game, just to pick on an easy target. I can now only get dopamine by you subscribing, I guess. So this was day one, and something definitely needs to change for this to be doable. Okay, so we have a couple new rules and ideas now. First of all, I can quit out of boss rooms, so if we peek into Margit and see that it's impossible, we don't have to waste half an hour gathering materials, and we are going to kill Grail every single time, since apparently the randomizer doesn't work on it and it still gives the same amount of runes as usual. Also, the giant is here again. Being able to run away helps, and the change to a slower, more calculated approach means we can actually get good levels and equipment. There is a Giant Phase 2 instead of Margit, again, so we can't proceed that way, but we can make it up the precipice to enter the plateau. Just one boss is on our way, let's find out who it is.
What? Sorry? Hello? Hello? Is anybody there? Magma Wyrm Placidusax? That explains the slow start. We do deal some damage. I think just don't get hit is the best strat. And he may glitch and die once he flies through. For a second, I thought they cut their tail. Okay. If we are farther away than the tail, then we avoid the explosion. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, no. It kinda works. It's just, what scares me is that they didn't hit me yet. And it might be a one-shot kill. What? Are they underground? I could hear the lightnings from there, so I was watching there, looking there. Wait, I think the fight... Okay, no, they're back. Okay, so this is the laser attack. I can say for sure that this is a laser attack. Ah. We survived it? Okay. Hope they don't do it again. Do some, like, useless attack. I think I could not see that one coming. It was... The light was, like, in the wall. No. Don't fly away. Okay. It's what? Like, 4 hits? Staggered? Can we do it, actually? Please. Yeah. Since we are in the plateau, the festival started, meaning we can now fight Radahn. And I wasn't too scared for this one, because we can summon the boys in this arena that are going to help out a lot, so we can just sit back and watch the fight. Okay, maybe we have to swing a couple of times. Now we have one great rune, and we just need another one to enter the capital. But with an impossible Margit on our way, our only options are the Volcano Manor. Is she not going to give me the key? For which we need to find the drawing room key, or the academy that requires another key. And with an insane stroke of luck, we find not only one in the location where it's supposed to be, and I can assure you it's randomized, so this is basically impossible, but also the other one just inside the academy. The world is a oyster, but we begin with the academy that is supposed to be easier. We peek inside the boss room, and it's Malenia, so we get out of there and go for the manor. Only that this area is pretty hard, so it's all good up until the last enemy before the boss fight. So, no hero death against a strong boss, no cool anime moment where I sacrifice myself to save my friends, just the wrong enemy in the wrong place, and it's over. Back to the drawing board. Well, that's depressing, but it also showed me something really important. We are good enough to do it, we just need to get a good run. Okay, the next one wasn't it, but I found out I had a problem with the randomization, in that it was only shuffling bosses among their own pool, meaning that a major boss was substituted only by another major one, minor bosses with minors, field with field, and so on, so now it's properly randomized. But the one after that was the run. Does that happen every time I say the run? Let's just ignore it. We have a couple of free levels at the beginning, since the game first assigns you a weapon and then makes sure that you can wield it. Margit looks easy, and we can find a summon too. So this is already looking pretty good, but what really pushes us over the edge is a very, very, very lucky find. A merchant sells us a plus 7 spear, since it's a drop in the game if you kill patches. And to put it into perspective, there are only 3 weapons already upgraded that we can find in the whole game. Think of every useless drop and pickup you've gotten in the game. Every item, every shop, every fruit, everything. And just 3 of those can be one of these weapons. So basically we take it and don't ask any questions. We can use a Bloodash of War and an Estoc to take out Grayol, and then we have to fight Margit, that luckily was one of the first assassins and bosses in the game, so she already begins the fight at half HP, is very passive, and in general the game does scale up or down bosses, but stronger ones are going to remain stronger, so this is all in all pretty easy, and we can for the first time take out Margit. But the easy stuff is over, because now we have to run through the main gate, since we don't have the key for the interior.
intended path on the left, and as we saw before, it just takes one bad enemy to take us out. Some shrimps and some luck later and we can get into the fight. There isn't much more we can do here, and I was stoked to find out who it was going to be.
Okay, 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 the damage is there. Stagger? Cannot get a riposte, that sucks. Because it's on the stairs. They killed two of the... Okay, one of the boys is still alive. That's Elden Stars. Might kill us. Okay, Elden Stars does no damage. Remember, like, obviously the HP and the... Like, the enemies scaled. Hey, still two heals. And it's almost dead. Managed to dodge it somehow. Is the fish done?
Fish hunted, and we can almost lose the run to a random invisible enemy underground. I swear this mod always does everything it can to take you out. But then we can find a twig that works as an extra life. And then I curse myself 30 seconds later.
I don't know if these enemies are like insanely hard. They do look very strong. Yeah, they are very strong.
So yeah, this is how the twig works. Thanks for the demonstration, Francis. We couldn't find the key to the academy, so the only direction we can take is towards the precipice. That could be a very easy area. I mean, if not for the enemies that follow you up the stairs, the ones that can shoot you down from the stairs, and the ones that are just too wide and block the way.
At least it wasn't a lobster. Oh, come on.
Really?
What do we do now?
Okay, it's a nightmare basically, but we can lure some of them and then we can make our way through without falling down. And it's time for the boss, that is almost mandatory, so we could be in a horrible spot. And it's Placidusox again. I mean, it's kinda okay since we already beat them once, so we can probably do it again, but I wanted a cool fight moment to build up a story, not something you already saw 10 minutes ago. Also, the odds of this boss being here twice in a row are basically none, so I'm either really lucky or incredibly unlucky. At least it was even more bugged this time, so I have something to show you, and you use the pillar to block the laser at the end. Okay, it was kind of a nail biter though. Placidusox done with, again, we make it to the plateau, meaning that we end up in the worst storm in the history of the lands between, actually never seen anything this bad, and that the Radahn's festival started, so we can go beat him up. And when I say beat him up, I mean it, because we could hold back and not summon the boys to have a fair fight, but the game is trying to kill me in every way it can, so why should I be honorable? Also, look how cool they look when they walk towards him. I use a Rot Grease in the fight, in hindsight absolutely useless, but Morgoth does have a lot of AoE attacks, so I was scared for the boys, since we can resummon them, but not infinite times. In case you're wondering, they do have randomized outfits, but not weapons, probably because if not, their movesets don't work. And I could say something more about this fight, but it's a straight up massacre. 10 more seconds of this and it shows up on live leak. This means that we have the second great rune, so we can enter the capital. And along the way we meet one of the most interesting merchants of the run.
You can buy bolts. A little less expensive bolts. Bolts again. Very cheap bolts or very cheap bolts. And flaming bolts, for the same price as the normal ones.
The sentinel is on the way though, and I was kind of scared since it's usually a pretty tough enemy. Okay, honestly, I have no idea who this guy is, so I used a Rotten Grease out of sheer panic. It turned out to be a pretty easy fight, but this starts to show the first crack in our armor. With so many possible randomized bosses, we are likely to find one that I don't know well enough or at all, since I basically only done challenge runs in the past year, and we only have one shot at them, so we either learn them during the fight, or we perish. So, for most of the viewers, this looked like a generic rebalanced Everjail fight, but I started to get a bit worried. The path inside the capital was a nightmare too, since it's very narrow and there are a ton of enemies, and it's the same in all three sections. The rooftops?
Let's see if you're lucky.
The sewer-like part?
Okay, this sucks. I'll try to run.
And remember that if any ranged enemy spawns, we have to clear them, since there's a big ladder at the end. And the last and toughest one, the tree branch.
It could break the run. Okay, I already see a giant. Like, we could just die here.
It's way too narrow to just run through, and the fall is deadly. So I first tried to lure the giant with the bow to make him fall down, and it only succeeded in making him really angry. So I figured I had to run for it.
Please, 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 thank you. Okay, and there's a bunch more enemies. Oh no.
So yeah, a lightning ball was on the way. One of the strongest enemies around, and also one that doesn't have an hitbox or HP. It just stands there. So I took the approach that served me so many times in life.
I mean, if we die, we die, I guess.
And as always, it works, but it was just a short moment of relief before the next boss fight.
Ah. Old friend.
The guy that killed us twice already in this challenge is trying to do it again. A moment so unlucky that I'm starting to think there's foul play involved.
Do I think something happened with the bias? Because it's strange that we got three major bosses here.
What I'm talking about here, since speaking while playing this game is hard, is that in all the previous major boss fights but Margit, we got another major boss. Godric was the fish, Malak was Placidusax, and yes, Malak is considered a major boss. Radahn was Morgoth, and now Pisfrey is the giant. So I thought that something went wrong in the randomization, since it's what I thought I fixed before doing these last two runs. I quickly realized that fighting him here sucks. He keeps on hiding his leg inside walls, and most of his attacks, roll included, have a huge area of effect, so dodging them is very hard or straight up impossible, especially when he starts to use fire. Like if they have the arena in mind when they make a boss fight. I still feel confident though. We dealt a little over half HP, we have a little less than half heals, so it should all be good. But not only he hides his weak spot, it's also really hard to recognize some of his attacks since he's always half-bugged into the ceiling, so a couple of bad decisions later and I have no more heals. We are one hit from death, the run is on the brink of being dead, so I need to clutch it. I somehow remember that we have raw meat dumplings, a consumable that heals us for a bit but also poisons us, and I managed to use them from the inventory in the middle of the fight to have a small breathing room, and with the giant rolling around we can fight in a better spot. We get hit by a weird attack that would have killed us, and with a good pattern with the flames we can heal again, but the poison is going to eventually kill us, so we have to get really reckless to win.
Actually? Yeah! Wow, this was insanely clutch.
So yeah, I was pretty pumped at this point. But our next step was Morgoth. And if I'm right about the randomization not working, it's going to be a major boss, so most likely a big problem.
Can we see inside the arena from that small gap? If it's a fire giant phase 2, I'm going to lose my mind. Oh, here goes nothing. Ah, the cutscene has to start, I guess. Ah. Okay, no, so we just got insanely unlucky in the three previous tries.
Get him, boys! We slaughtered this poor guy. It was definitely one of the boss fights in Elden Ring. And here we get the medallion and we can get into the Frozen Lands. Only a few bosses left. Wait, this isn't the medallion?
Don't worry, we can just use the lift. We don't have to run around and find the talisman. It's a setting you can put in the randomizer, I think. I hope.
I was pretty sure that I did everything correctly, but if I'm making a big deal about this, something probably happened.
Oh no. Do we have to actually find it?
His smile and optimism gone. Okay, I cut it short. We can buy tips on where a required item is from Kale, it costs 12k runes, so now we know that we have to go down to Nokron, meaning more bosses. Post-production Francis here, I just noticed that in this clip I get 3 twigs, and when I go to my inventory it's only 1 twig. I honestly didn't notice it while live, No idea what happened there. I don't know, like, take a guess in the comments if you know why that happened. The first one is supposed to be the Mimic tier, and they thought it was going to be kind of easy, because the tier is easy. But luck strikes again with one of the most hated bosses of all time. By me, at least. Okay, maybe I hate too many boss fights. But at this point, I wasn't sure I was even getting the tip for the right item, so I went inside the fight and tried to beat it. Also because we got a twig along the way, but I'm not familiar with the fight. And since I didn't want to throw away the run doing something I'm not even sure I should do, I quit out. I know it's kinda cheating, but I felt cheated by the game for not giving me the medallion. After making sure we were going the right way, also known as straight up looking in the files if the medallion is there, I went in the fight again to try and take down the bird, this time without quitting out. Not that I needed to, since the trash took itself out by jumping down the arena, but like Pinky swear I wouldn't have done it. Probably. With the game clearly telling me that we are doing something right, we can go towards the gargoyles, that are actually a random knight, and that will give us the medallion. Also, to atone for my sins, I gave Kale some other runes for free, like if we ask for the specific location of the item, a thing we can do but costs more. We are back on track, we can get to the Frozen Lands, get scared because I forgot that Densha invaded us when we came back, and then get scared again because I almost fell down while reading chat. This area without golems is much, much easier, but in the later section my game stuttered terribly every time I looked where there's supposed to be a fight, so we had to proceed looking at our feet. For sure some of you sickos think it should be a permanent feature. Then we can enter the fight, that at this point you know I'm dreading, because even a single bad one can put a stop to this whole run. But luckily, it's just a tree. I try to choke it as much as I can, but it's obviously easy. So even with a bunch of mistakes, we have no problems and can proceed to the next area. And it's done. Okay. Okay. Oh no, it's two phases. What is it? Okay. Apparently chat was right. The problem is that I don't know this fight at all. It finally happened. A hard fight that I didn't know, and it's a phase 2 nonetheless, so I did what every honorable fighter would do in a situation like this. I quit out, or as I like to call it, tactical retreat, because I mean, two full HP bosses isn't really fair. I'm just making up excuses at this point, but I came in with a bow, because since we can ride a horse in this arena, why not exploit it? But turns out that not only he has pretty long reach with his attacks, he even has a phase 2, where he grows wings and starts to throw cold lightning from his hands. If not for this one thing, I could have beat him, so I quit out again. Also, if you do this, remember to not get on the horse in the phase transition. If you spend more than 6 seconds in the air stuck, the game kills you. Back to the drawing board, and this time we decided that we probably need Alexander if we want to do this, so we ran all the way to the bottom of the manor, avoided Radahn walking on the lava, and talked to the big boy himself. Now we can get back in again, fight the tree, and then summon him. He is tuned to fight the giant, without really being able to dodge or focus the weak point, so I expected him to be great here. But for some reason, he just chokes it. I don't know if it's because the soldier has a weird body shape and is trying to go towards his legs, but something in his AI doesn't work, and he just stands there getting punched, barely retaliating. And do you realize how annoying it is to lose here? How ironic it is that after a whole challenge plagued by the fire giant, we are on the brink of defeat because of his arena and double phase? I tried not to quit out again, also called I choked and got deleted by a combo that also deals frostbite damage, so that is the twig gun, and we have no more extra lives. But this is the only way through, so I needed to get back in again and win. Only this time, I had a plan. When the soldier is in phase 2, he has a bunch new attacks, and one of those is a dash through the air that ends with him a bit behind us. I at first tried to make him fall down the arena, the obvious strategy, but it doesn't work, since this arena does have edge protection. And then I remembered an exploit present in the game when it first released, that allowed you to kill the giant. You could bait him up a cliff and make him fall down, resulting in an instant kill. They patched it since, but I had a hunch that they only patched it for the giant, and it was still, somehow, doable for other enemies. So I decided to stand on top of the cliff and try to lure him to do the attack. Only that, most of the time after it missed, he just disappeared, since it's a mechanic present here if the boss gets too far away in the arena. We had many close calls, but I couldn't quite do it, up until, well, this happened.
Oh. Maybe?
Oh! Oh,
Okay, did it work? He did the dying animation. He died? He died? I think it worked. Maybe the game has to realize what happened.
But alas, it didn't work. I mean, it technically did, but I spent some time in the arena. The game never dealt damage to the boss or killed him, he was nowhere to be found, and the HP bar stayed on screen. I didn't know what to do. Because, let's be honest, if I didn't quit out a bunch of times, the run would be dead at this point. And the deathless run shouldn't just be one where you quit out just before dying. You should be committed to the fight when you enter it, but you can have my raw opinion and reaction live.
Honestly, I think that if you break the game because of the randomizer, and the game stops working, you beat the game. You beat the randomizer, at least.
So yeah, I think that we saw all that the randomizer had to offer, and even if I didn't get to the end, it's always more about the journey than the destination. So I say that you can beat Elden Ring like it's a roguelike, only I couldn't. Okay, to be fair, I streamed one more day, and after randomly finding Tish and having a super good Alexander RNG, I could proceed in the run. But it still ended in the fight with Malikef, with the Blackblade Kindred phase 1, and the, I think most people would argue, worst fight in the game, Double Crucible Knight. And yes, it was all done with a sign and a title showing my hatred for the Fire Giant. The best to almost do it. Also, the mod is in the description, it's crazy fun.